This is Puppy Agility Week 2. These are exercises 5 and 6. We'll talk just briefly about exercise 5 in class. We're working on rear end awareness, so this idea that the dog doesn't necessarily naturally have a sense of what's behind their front shoulders. We need to teach them that there actually is something back there that they need to pay attention to. So in class, we're working with a variety of surfaces. We're working with a ladder. As you get more advanced, you can start to incorporate things like this box. So get her used to the idea that, see, we have to pick up feet. Good girl. All right, big dog in a little box. We have to pick up feet, back feet in particular, in order to get into the place that we need to be. This will build a little bit of coordination. It'll make it easier when they're working with obstacles and things like that to stay all four rooted nice and firmly.
Good girl.
So have them walk over. If you have an extension ladder that you can lie down, anytime that your dog picks up their back feet, click and treat. Have them move just through the rungs of the ladder as it lays flat on the ground. If you have other strange surfaces, we also want to socialize them to different types of textures or surfaces. So, you know, gravel, grass, wet grass is a weird one for some dogs. Get them used to concrete, walking over a crate, maybe that has been something metal. If you're in the Chattanooga area, the glass bridge over by the Arts District is another good surface to practice with. So anything strange that they might encounter, so we don't have a fear of that, especially since most of you are still in the critical socialization window that sort of ends somewhere between 16 and 20 weeks. So just get them used to, good girl, checking out different things, walking on different things. So the second exercise in this set is the one jump exercise, we call it. And the idea is in class, we have them walk around a bucket, but realistically, we're going to transfer it to a jump like this one over here. And that's a pretty low jump just for the purposes of demonstration. So you don't have to have one of these to do the exercise. I'll show you where this ends up so that you have a sense of what we're building to. And then I'll show you how you can practice it in your home with objects you have around the house. So at least initially, or rather I should say finally, the thing that we're building to is this idea that we're going to send the dog, same arm, same leg. Good girl. I'm a little slow with that. Receive her on the other side of the jump. Look, I was a little slow. She was fine. So we're sending the dog. It's a basic rock step. So forward, side. That's the footwork here. Forward with the side of the dog hand side, just square with the other foot. The treat should be in the hand away from the dog. And we want to send with the same arm and leg. Good girl. And then just receive them back to get their treat. And the click, you'll notice I did about halfway out. That's just a trigger for her. I've done the thing I was asked. Come back and receive my reward. That builds that a little bit more easily. So that's where we're going to end up with this. We're not starting there, though. We need to first socialize the dog to the idea of going around an object. That's really what we're trying to send. So I'm going to use this bicycle pump. If you have a stool, you can use a stool. A bucket works pretty well. That's what we're going to use in class. I'm going to give her a second to explore that a bit. Good girl. And then we're going to just do the same exercise. So same dog hand, side and leg, dog hand, side, arm and leg, and receive with the opposite. Good. Come. Right? Good girl. And your dog is not going to know what to do with this right up front. So most likely what's going to happen is your dog will explore the obstacle a little bit. When they start, we don't want to lure them, but when they start to move around the obstacle, click, call them happily, get them back. Riku, good girl. Ready? We're gonna go. Yes! Good girl. And just draw them back to you. Let them explore it a little bit. If they're having trouble with getting around, that's okay, we're just starting. As they get about halfway, sometimes even just a quarter, you can click that thing, they start to move around it, click, and just lure the rest of the way. And that's okay for right now. We'll get rid of the lure as we move further on. But for the time being, that's the exercise for the week. Just walk around. You as a human, same side once they start to understand it. Come. She's doing the right thing. I've got her on the wrong side. arm and leg move like they're tied together. Other arm steps out, other leg steps out, arm holds the tree. There you go. Good girl. Good girl. There you go. And that's it for week 2.